Gonna run away. See, the door is right over. There's a door. There's a doorknob. You know where the door's at. You too nervous?
No, I don't plan on running away.
You're not gonna run away today?
Are you?
No.
Well, then I won't either.
Then what are you gonna do?
Marry you.
Why?
Because I love you.
You gonna marry me in this outfit?
Yes. Do you like it?
Mm-hmm.
I bought these shoes especially for the wedding.
Where's your veil that you were talking about?
Well, you don't get to see that. That's the extra added touch at the end.
Well, Trudy's supposed to be here to pick you up. How come she's not here yet?
I don't know, because...
She's probably still doing her hair, that's why.
Oh, well, that could be here forever.
She's probably been up since about 6 this morning.
Anyway.
Trying to do her hair.
Yeah, right. Okay, you can shut off the camera anytime. Is
she going to make sure that she makes it today?
Yep. I'm going to make her all beautiful too.
We were just talking about you.
You were?
Yeah.
What did you say?
We were wondering why you were so late, and we figured
so
it was because of your hair. I mean, look
so
at that hair.
I didn't do it even yet. I just...
Look at that hair.
I was going to wait.
It's the natural look.
That's right.
Now you shut the camera off because I'm going to get the veil and you can't see it.
Yeah.
You already saw my tux. We have to be even.
That was
here.
Your choice.
Well, you know.
Your choice. Now shut off the camera.
I saw Lyle in his text too, and he doesn't have to go get it fitted by those women down there that want to maul him.
Shut off the camera. And now we're married. How do you feel about that?
I feel like I need to let out some stress, you know, by beating you or something.
I don't like that.
Okay, well, how about play video games?
Okay, let's go play video games. You know. And this is our view from our motel, the Red Lion Inn in Seattle. And now we're going down in the elevator. Isn't this cool?
The same elevator we just had sex on 2 minutes ago.
We did not.
That's why I'm sweating. So I got this gloss here.
He's a pinball wizard, for sure.
That song that the Who sang?
Elton John did that, too.
Eva, this is not a woman's game. That's why you're going to lose.
Oh.
Hey, let's watch this ball here. Go right down in between those two flippers.
Not a chance.
There it goes. I told you, we saw it on video camera.
Rip off. Rip. Gotta beat the
right. You got some work cut out.
What happened?
You lost.
Oh, I got an extra ball.
Oh, well, you got lucky then, because we know I'm the pinball wizard first. Admit it. See? Well, right down between them two flippers.
Yeah, that goes far. I haven't turned it on yet. But now I did. And here we are, driving away from the new Denver airport towards the mountains in our brand new Toyota Tercel, exactly like I used to own.
And look, other than the mountains, it's just as flat as Nebraska.
Look, we'll go this way.
I mean, look, you can see forever. It's just like Nebraska until you get to the mountains.
That's why we're moving to Nebraska someday. Because we're close to Colorado.
Eva wants to take her grandchild away from her grandparents and move to Nebraska.
No, I didn't say that. They can come stay as long as they like. They can even move there if they want. Okay, we're on our way. Okay, now we're... worst of the traffic. We're on Highway 36 and we're headed up to the mountains. Any comments from you, Lamar?
Nope, no comments.
Okay.
Not this time, I just can't wait to get there.
Me either. Okay, now we're about 15, 20 miles outside Estes Park, and we are up in the mountains.
We are at Roosevelt National Park.
Roosevelt National Park. Cars have a little trouble going up the hill, but we'll make it there. It's really pretty out here.
On our way to Estes Park, we see all of our little friendly elk standing out here eating. Wouldn't Lyle be happy just to take his rifle out here and call that one right there? Or that one that's running away there. I said Lyle's name and it's running away. They all are.
Smart Look at animals. That.
Anyway, still on our way to Estes Park. It's pretty. It's a pretty drive.
We need to shoot with cameras. This is our cabin.
Well, if I can open the door here, I guess we can't go in. Oh, look, champagne for us, or sparkling cider, I should say.
Wow. This is our cabin.
This is our little cabin. It's cute, isn't it?
It's adorable. I'm gonna get the outside view here.
Let me turn on more lights.
This is the view from our front door.
See?
It's our patio. Works for me. We're never leaving. Look at these.
And a fireplace in our bedroom, too. Actually, the fireplace goes to both sides.
What a deal. All right. Do you have any comments?
Yes. Let me see the camera. Don't turn it off.
Oops, shaking it around a little bit. My comment is, yes. This here is a woman I love that we're looking at here in the mirror, or in the video camera.
That's me.
This is a woman I loved and we're going to be together all our life, and this is our little child in the belly.
You can't see. No, you can't see.
And there goes a butt out the door. Okay, this is our first day we actually get to enjoy this place by running around and seeing the sights.
Yeah.
And this is a view from...
just to the end of our little road. It's about noon and it's about 60 degrees.
How come it says... our cabin and our car right back there. That's a swimming spa. And more mountains.
Now we're gonna take a walk.
And there's my lovely bride.
This way.
This here is the entrance into our place, and again in the background you have the mountains.
In the
pretty
foreground,
tall.
We have me.
Of course, you see up in the sky, the sun is shining. Blue sky all the way around today. There's Eva. She wants to take some pictures down by this little stream down there underneath that bridge. Eva, the master photographer.
That's me.
There's a close-up. Wave, Eva. Say hi to your family and friends.
Hi, family and friends.
And there's our little child. It's in the the biscuit in the basket.
Anyway, isn't it pretty here?
Here's a stream that Eva wanted to take a picture of. Got some snow down here.
Goes by our cabin.
And there's no snow up on those mountains, but in the behind us, way in the background, there's plenty of snow in those mountains. Could almost drink out of that water there, huh? Snow on the sides. On our trip up, there's a lot of snow, like in the shady areas, but not a lot on the mountains or roads through on our trip up here.
Here we are.
Of course, we're going to drive up and to see some of that snow. We have probably a 20-30 minute drive till we get up to the snow level.
And here we are.
I can't see no red light. Where's the red light at?
It's on.
Oh, it's too bright and sunny out here. Ah. I already took this side of the stream, so you can take my picture on this side.
Okay. I know these two sides of the stream look totally different, don't they?
And you know, it's amazing, we have a stream here, and the place that we're staying is, of course, Streamside Cabin. There's one little cabin right in the background there.
Appropriately named, wouldn't you say?
I would say Streamside is the appropriate name for the cabin, because there's a stream.
I would think so too. Anyway, it's really pretty.
Still a little bit brown from the winter.
Yeah, I think so. And still some snow?
A little bit. I bet you that water's cold down there.
Blue sky.
I'm gonna go down by the water.
You are?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll follow you there. There he goes. Man on a mission. Hope he doesn't fall in. That would be really cold.
If the snake comes up, I'll catch it and I'll save it for you.
No thanks. Catch me a snake, I don't think so. Is it cold?
Definitely cold. Oh, look, I'm gonna take your picture up there.
You know, I can get really close to you, even way up here. Even my handsome husband taking a picture of me. It's crazy. We've shown you this view yet. This is the other way off of our cabin. I don't know where Leroy went. There he is. Okay, now we go where? Downtown?
Yep.
Now we're off to downtown. This is our new car that we bought. Thank you everyone for buying us this new car. Actually, this is our rental car, but it's exactly the same car I used to own. Isn't that crazy? That's because it's our cabin. We're off.
See, we have deer here at our cabin.
This is right outside our front door.
Yep. We parked right behind us, and our cabin's right behind us, and the deer are coming up. There's two now. I think they followed Eva because she got out and took some pictures of them a little bit ago, and now they want to come up here and say hi to her and beg her for some food.
They're probably enjoying the nice weather.
Hey, Eva says I can zoom in. I already did zoom in.
Oh.
I zoomed in even closer. Can't get the full deer in there. Where'd the other one go?
Way over to your left.
Way over
your
to
your other left, honey.
No, it's right there. I already got the other one. Oh. That one's still eating right over there. There's supposed to be three of them.
I think the other one's still down grazing.
The other one took off. It's taken off way over there. But they're pretty tame. They see us here. They don't take off. We were told when we got here that they were going to beg for food. And they'd keep begging. So yeah, we've seen elk on our way here. And we've seen deer on our way to town today. And now the deer have come to visit us finally.
They heard we were here, wanting to wish us well. Isn't that crazy?
This one here is kind of skeptical. See? Wonders what the hell I want. All I want to do is take your picture. Supposedly they have two babies that belong to one of the deer that's on this property.
Maybe we can find them later.
Look at that. Lyle, how could you ever shoot such a cute animal? Look how pretty they are.
I think he's going to meet his friends. Has decided we don't have
any food. Why don't you walk out there?
And do what?
Act like you have food.
I don't have any.
Here, I will then.
Okay.
See? Yeah, hold out your hand. He was afraid of these deer, I think.
No, I'm not. I just don't have any. Well, I have the camera. And there it goes. Leroy scared it off. Nice butt shot.
Apparently the mountain lions eat on, this is what they feed on, the mountain lions, all these deer that they have up there.
Really?
Yep. At least that's what the book said that I read.
It's just checking us out. What do you think, Leroy?
I think they're beautiful. Not as beautiful as you, but then nothing in the world can compare to your beauty.
I think I'll go back to the deer. You're crazy.
Oh, here comes the third, four. There's actually four here. Two down there, there's these two. Can you see the one behind the tree down there?
Yeah. This camera's got some major zoom power.
Oh, and there's another one way down there. One, two, three, four, five, six. Six deer.
You're just walking all over the place. It's amazing.
I bet you if we had a carrot or two, I bet you they'd be like, right?
I bet you're right.
But it's illegal to feed the deer. So, of course, we're not going to do that.
Because we don't do things that are illegal.
We know that people like Lionel Lee would probably feed them, try to hog tie them, and eat them for dinner, but we're not that type of people.
No, we're not. Okay, well, that was a deer show. This is the front view of our cabin, called Morning Glory, because it's facing toward the sun in the morning. We like it. And there's the trees. There's the other cabin. I'm sure you can hear the birds. And there's our little car. There's Leroy. And there's our deers. Playing in the meadow. In the stream right in front of our cabin. In the beautiful mountains. There's my handsome husband. Pretty neat, don't you think?
Eva, do you want to say hi?
Hi.
Tell them where we're at.
Long's Peak, and it's elevation 14,000 some feet.
That one right there?
Yep.
And we're going to climb to the top of that today, aren't we?
Yeah.
It's very
with our bare hands.
Very windy out here today. Skies.
Well, here we are at one of the lookout points.
Eva, is this a rock you want to bring back to your dad's house for his garden?
Yes, that's it.
Okay, well, you help me and we'll pick it up, throw it in the trunk and bring it back.
Okay, that's what we're bringing you, Dad. Big enough for you?
You might have to send it UPS or something, though.
Yeah.
If he pays for it.
Okay.
He pays for the shipping.
It's a deal. So what do you think of the Rocky Mountain National Park?
It's beautiful. Let's move here, and after we have our grandchild, let's move over here.
Okay.
Okay, Eva, go ahead and you can tell us where we're at now.
Now we're at Bear Lake. Up, I would guess, about 9,000 feet. We're up really high because we can hardly walk without huffing and puffing. Anyway, these are... I don't know exactly which ones these are, but... Aren't they pretty?
Oops, who's that funny looking for? Oh, that's Eva.
Cover the land so you don't get a flyer in the front. Yeah, I did.
It's pretty.
On your lens so you don't get a lens flare. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know. So when the picture comes out, it's not all sunny.
Sometimes it shows a dotted bright spot. Just maybe.
Should I just angle? I don't have one, so should I just angle it?
No. You just park where you have it. Uh-huh. Where you have it. Then have her stand right here and hold her up with her hand so that the hand can be shadowed on the wind.
Oh, okay.
All good. Yeah. Stay right now where the sun is.
That's
just easy. Open it up. See where all the...
Where we drove up from. Eva and I are going to climb to like that peak over there.
And then we have some swampland we can sell you.
And we'll go over to that one. We'll go down a little bit. Then to that one, like right up to there. We might be a little bit tired, so we'll probably stop and eat lunch up there. Climb back down.
Yeah, and we're going up without food or water or anything.
Hit that peak. Actually, we might actually do some sledding down that hill.
Yeah.
See, that looks kind of fun to go right down that little area.
Fast way down.
And we'll go over to there. Those peaks, we're just gonna take take a look at those. We'll probably be tired after we were at this peak over here.
Because, you know, that one over there, I think, is Long's Peak, and that's about 14,000 feet.
So. Yeah, I think that that might take us a while to hike. So we're just going to do the first three that we showed you. This one, that one, and that one. And we can use this one just to warm up on. Eva and I are now tromping through the woods up here by Bear Lake. Eva just fell on her butt. No, just a minor slip.
I just slipped, it didn't fall. What?
I'm just videotaping you, and this is how pretty it is up here. See all the snow, trees, mountains behind. And there goes Eva tromping through the woods. And I'm following. Where this goes, nobody knows. But all I do know is that this is slick. And it's hard to breathe up here. Follow the signs. What does that sign say? Bear Lake, next 500 feet only for wheelchairs. Where are we going? Well, we'll figure this out.
We'll get back to you.
Eva, did we figure out where we're going?
Figured it out. It's this way.
Okay. It's a lake straight ahead of Eva. It's all frozen over. Not much of a lake. It's white. It's pretty windy up here. It's actually pretty warm too. It feels great. Still got blue skies, a few clouds.
I think I'm going ice skating.
You're going ice skating?
Yeah.
And look, we have wildlife out here. The Eva monster.
Do people have to walk me across?
Really? Yeah, you can walk across it because it's all frozen over.
I don't think I would.
I don't think I'd trust Eva because I never have, and it looks like it's probably a pretty big lake. Trail goes all the way around the road too far over there, huh?
You're standing right close to it.
great. Anyway, this is Bear Lake. You can't really see it because it's totally frozen over. But we hiked out here anyway just to see it and bring you this lovely shot and ourselves. So.
There's a little picnic area behind us too. You can see if there's some trees if you turn around.
Kind of slow, it's kind of a bit dizzy. Yeah, but it's the river. Up in the mountain. There we are. You can see it. I'm not scared of her. Well, they are a little bit, but not much to go anywhere. And this huge, beautiful building is the Stanley Hotel in Estes Park. It's a very famous place. And it's where Stephen King spent a lot of his time when he was writing The Shining. And when you're here, you can kind of see why. It kind of reminds you of it. It's kind of strange. They have a beautiful view out here.
The altitude here is 7,600.
Wow. Beautiful view of Lake Estes in the town. See, right in front of the motel here, there's this like tennis court and swimming pool, which reminds me of The Shining, which had the maze right in front of the motel. So that's what I think he came up with that idea from. Just
of course,
a guess.
The pool and the hot tub are empty this time of year.
Yes. But you remember in the movie how there was the maze right in front of the big hotel on the hill, just like this is?
You know what that is right there?
What?
That's Mount Olympus.
It is.
Mm-hmm. Like the camera.
Huh. Well, now you know.
There's Lake Estes out there.
But you know, The Shining was set in Colorado. So, this place is kind of eerie. It reminds me of it. It's kind of weird. But it's beautiful. Now, we're going to go inside and take a look. Okay, we're inside the motel now. And I keep thinking of when Stephen King called the Overlook Hotel. Total overlook. And there's like a music room and all the different kind of rooms, just like the play and then the movie. Creepy. There's a woman looking at a piano. Look at, they're right outside our front porch. Hi.
They're begging for food.
Do you want food?
Look how big your ears are. You're funny, Bambi. The little baby's ears as big as its mother's. I don't think that they like Oliver not giving him food, huh?
What's the matter? You don't like us? We're right on our front porch. Hey, got some food for you. Come on. He's getting some food for you. Yeah. Come here. Come here, look. Did we give you some food? Look at that.
That's all that we can feed him, though. We're not supposed to feed him bread. Aren't they cute?
He is.
I'm gonna go down and get food.
Okay. What's it here? Where's the line? That was very sad. He trusted Leroy, and Leroy didn't have any food. But he's keeping a close eye on him. Here he comes. No, I want to tape you. Do it. Do it.
Could you be scared of him or what?
No. They've lost faith in us. They hear somebody else. I think we've called our bluff too many times.
Huh?
So I think we've called our bluff too many times. They're going on to greener pastures. Not very smart, are you? Here, he found it. That's it.
The whole herd elk out here. On the way back, that's this park from Boulder.
is this beautiful or what? Isn't this pretty?
Yes, that is pretty. Look at our little sunrise.
Cute.
Staying in the morning glory.
Yep. I see her.
She's really come and visit.
Isn't it pretty? It's really beautiful.
Deer don't come down in the morning when it's sunny. Like early or late afternoon when it's a little bit cooler. There's our cabin from the outside. There's another cabin like attached to it on the back side. Actually there's, in this complex there's ours right there. There's one over there, there's one right behind that, and there's one right behind ours. Plus there's one downstairs over there. And the sun's coming up behind those trees right there. Don't know whose house that is. I don't think it's part of the cabins here though. And again, there's our little place. And yes, we'll miss it. But strange animals come out in the morning. Oops.
That's strange.
Well, we better get ready to go since it's about probably 20 till 7. We gotta take off out of here at 7.
And what do you think this fine morning, Leroy?
Well, I think that we had a nice day here. And we'll probably come back here someday.
I think so too.
Probably during the summer so we can do more hiking when we have our little child.
Yep. Horseback riding.
Which is only 4.5 months from today.
That's true. That's
so,
true.
Anyway, you better come in and eat breakfast because our breakfasts like Apple Jacks are nutritious. They get us going in the morning. And always remember A's for Apple and J's for Jacks.
And this is DIA. Denver International Airport, and we're here really early, so we're taping. Is this exciting? This is our gate. There's my husband. He doesn't look really happy, does he?
I'm tired.
This is the new airport. Actually, it's pretty easy to get around.
Show them the part of the airport over there.
Which part?
With the funny cop.
Okay. Roy wants me to show you the funny top of the airport over there. We'll zoom in on it. That's the other part. We had to go in this underground railroad thing to get over here. And we're here like an hour early, but we thought better early than late, so here we are. And that's Denver International Airport. And here we are. Bouncing along in the car, pulling back into our little house. And there's our excited doggy. Look how excited he is. Woo! I'm turning the corner.
Kato too.
And Kato too. Look at Kato. My goodness. Let's get out of the car. Look how excited Tucker is.
Good boy.
Oh, look at that. Happy dog. Happy dog. Yes.